Hello out there, my name is Dr. Antonio Ko, and I'm asking you to be part my partner. Now I've come on this channel to talk to you about what God put in my heart. You know what Jesus said? He said, the harvest is ripe, but the laborers are few. There's a big, vast harvest out there to be reaped into the kingdom of God. We see a lot of demonic activity going on right now through the internet, the social media. There's a lot of corruption right now. Decadence. People go to church, but many are not saved. There's so much information out there, but most of those informations are actually out to destroy people. The strength of the gospel is beginning to wane in many areas. Right in the city where we live, most people are not really evangelized. And God put it in my heart in 2016 to go into the nations of the earth, communities, towns, and cities to do crusades. This year, I'm doing 24. Now, I'm coming on this broadcast today to ask for your partnership. Now, in my previous broadcast, which has been repeated severally, I have come to ask for partnership for financial support, which is very vital. But on this particular broadcast, I'm coming to ask for support groups. Now, money is important, but I'm asking for people to partner with me in the area of support that's playing a supportive role. Now, there's no mission that succeeds without prayer. Through this telecast, I'm trusting God for nothing less than 500 prayer partners, those who will come and support us in prayer. I'm asking for people to partner with us so that in 2016, I know that 500 people are praying for us, praying for this channel, praying for our crusades, praying for our outreaches, our revival meetings across the nations, for success, for God to heal, for God to deliver, for the oppressed to be set free. And that's why I'm on this telecast today, to ask for support groups. As much as the money is vital, we also need people to support us in the area of prayer. Now, when we look at the support group, we break it into two today on this telecast. The first group is the prayer group, and the second is those that fit into the work group under the support groups we're talking about. Now, in the book of Exodus chapter 17, we find in verse 8, that when the children of Israel came against the Amalekites, the Bible tells us that Moses went up to the mountain and he lifted his hands. And the Bible says, as long as Moses lifted up his hands, the children of Israel prevailed over the enemies. Now, a time came that the hands of Moses became weak, and Moses got the support of two men. The Bible says they put a stone under the hands of Moses when the hand of Moses became weak. And these two men positioned the hands of Moses. And the Bible says, as long as he supported Moses, the children of Israel prevailed. As we travel from city to city holding crusades, we get to a point where most times we don't have much time to pray as we should pray. Yes, prayer is vital. We definitely give ourselves to prayer. We pray all the time. But we need people to support us. I'm trusting God through this broadcast for 500 people to support us in prayer. I need 500 prayer warriors to support us. I'm calling for prayer warriors. I want this group to come behind us in prayer to support us as we go in 2016 to preach, to teach, and to heal, and to deliver. Now, I want you to look inward and begin to ask God how you can fit into this group. All we need you to do is to pray for us as we travel. Have an itinerary which I'm going to mail to you by email. And give us a commitment to pray every day for us. Pray every day for this channel. I need 500 of you. Now, in the book of Colossians, the Bible tells us about a man by the name of Epaphras. The Bible says all Epaphras did was to pray for the church of Colossians. He prayed all the time for them. And the Bible tells us how Epaphras prayed. He was one man that was committed. Epaphras, the Bible didn't mention about his financial givings, but the Bible talked about his support that he gave through prayer. The Bible tells us that Epaphras, one of you, always laboring. That's in the book of Colossians chapter 4. 12. It says, Epaphras, who is one of you, a servant of Christ, salute you all, always laboring fervently for you in prayers that you may stand perfect, completing all of the will of God. Now I tell you a story. Many years ago, there was this church. The church was struggling. The minister of God was anointed. And an old woman came into the church. She didn't have money to give, but she loved the ministry and she began to pray every day, every night, and every hour. The more she prayed, the church began to grow and the church began to explode. The pastor of the church began to do crusades nationwide. Every time the pastor traveled, this woman would go up to the mountain and pray. She would fast. When her kids had gone to school, she would pray all day. She was poor. She was old. She didn't have money, but she prayed. She came behind this man of God and supported him in prayer. And because she prayed for this great servant of God, his ministry exploded tremendously. They began to grow in size. The church became large and swallowed her up, and she became so insignificant. The more the man of God moved, his fame spread abroad and great things happened. One day this old woman died. And when she died, the church began to reduce. The man wasn't getting results in his crusades the way he should. And then he stopped his meetings. He noticed that the church had diminished. The unction upon his life had diminished. Doors were shut. Funds were no longer coming in. And he went and prayed and started seeking the face of God. Lord, what happened to his ministry? He was asking God what happened to his ministry. Now, the more he prayed, he became more desperate. One day he had a dream. In the dream, God took him to heaven and showed him this old woman who had prayed and labored for him fervently in prayer. Yet so insignificant, yet the influence of her prayer caused the ministry to explode. And this woman had died and had gone to heaven and had been rewarded by God. Now finally the man came out of that vision and began to cry, and then looked for the family of that old woman. Finally found the house of this old poor lady and asked to see the children. And the children told this great servant of God all their mother did in her lifetime, that all mama lived to do was to pray. That was the secret of his ministry. I need you to join me to pray in 2016. This 12 months, volunteer to come behind us in prayer. The second group I want as partners today in this telecast is the group that will support to open doors and to work with us in different countries. I don't know where you are. You might be watching me now from Ghana, from Cameroon, from Gabon, from Malawi, from South Africa, wherever you're watching us, Tanzania, and you want us to come to do crusades in your country or in your city. Now, we can partner together. You can come in to support us. You can open the doors, help us to get the halls, secure the places, while we do the funding, the preparations, and come in with our equipment. You might just be the key. Your job is to help us organize so that these programs can be so successful. Now, in the book of Romans chapter 12, we find in Romans chapter 16, verse 3, Paul began to talk about individuals like Priscilla. I said, greet Priscilla and Aquila, my helpers in Christ. We need you to help us, to come behind us, to play supportive role. The Bible said, Paul talked about Priscilla and Aquila, helpers in Christ, who for my life laid down their own necks. In other words, there was Priscilla and Aquila, they were helpers in Christ. They put their life on the line for the outreaches of Paul to succeed. Now I'm trusting God that you become my Aquila and my Priscilla, that will lay down your necks to see our outreaches in 2016 succeed. And he further on goes on to say in verse 6, he says, greet Mary, who bestowed much labor on us. He said, greet Mary. She bestowed much labor on us. We need those to give finances. We also need those who can come behind us and play supportive roles in prayer, and also to assist us as a workforce to open doors of cities community. Now call us, let us know. I'm trusting God for 500 partners to come behind us to pray, to support us, to work with us in different countries. Let us know. As I come to the close of this broadcast, I want you to understand that all of these things we do is not in vain. The harvest is much. You know what the Bible tells us in the book of Revelation chapter 3, verse 8, it says, I know the work, thy works. Behold, I have set before thee an open door, and no man can shut it, for thou had little strength, and hast kept my word, and hast not denied my name. Partner with us. God sees our works. Come behind us. Play a supportive role. Come and work with us. In 2016, I have a mandate to do 20 crusades. Pastor Oko, I want to be a part of your prayer team. Pastor Oko, I want to come and work with you people. I want to open doors. I want to bring you to my city, my country, community, to do revivals in your church. You could be a pastor watching us right now. Call us. Let us know how you can be part of our team. Let us work together and see the kingdom of God advance. The Lord bless you. Give us a call. Call us on this number. Go online and sign to become our partner. Be part of our support group to pray and to work with us. Be our Priscilla, Aquila. Be our Mary. The Lord bless you.
What a friend we have in Jesus. All our sins and griefs to bear. What a privilege to carry everything to God in prayer. Oh, what peace we often forfeit. This pain we bear, all because we do not carry everything to God in prayer. Oh, have we trials and temptations? Their trouble anyway.